Hello everyone and welcome to Let's Play Infernal Climber. I'm your comrade Real Soviet Bear, and with me are two wonderful people and one okay person actually.
Yeah, Chitlin.
Hello. Wow, way to assume.
I mean, he's not wrong, but at the same time, super rude.
Yeah. Anyway, hello, it's here with me are Loco.
Say hello. Yep. Loco.
Hello, Chitlin.
Hi.
Hello, Torpid.
Hello, Torpid.
I didn't tell you to say it. Never mind.
Fuck! I'm not kidding. Fuck!
Okay.
Why is the title of the game doing like a news ticker thing?
I don't know. There's a lot of janky stuff about this game.
I see the reason.
Yeah.
I saw Unity flash there.
Unity isn't a bad thing, but anyway, Infernal Climber is a little game made by Arc System Works, who are the people who make Guilty Gear, BlazBlue, and all sorts of other
anime trash.
Anime trash, yeah.
They developed it? I thought they only published it.
No, they developed it as well.
Oh, okay.
So, Infernal Climber is a little Dark Souls-like, Zelda-like something. We're just gonna go into this semi-blind, since this is attempt two at actually...
I'm fully blind.
The Dark Souls of Legend of Zelda.
Jesus.
Or Zelda-born, as they call it in the industry.
No, shut the fuck up.
Do the industry actually call it that?
No!
Yeah, that's a term. Anyway, we're gonna pick our character first, and there are a few archetypes that might evoke certain Souls-like memories. So we have the young warrior. We have the royal knight.
Why are they all winking permanently?
Look, I don't know. We'll probably learn as we play.
Because your character is horribly ugly.
Yeah.
Oh, well, that's a shame.
Wow, look at that, the staff. That is like a giant ice cube.
I like it.
It could also be
commemorative soap stuck around the staff.
Innocent prisoner.
Commemorative soap? I'm sorry, what?
The Pope soap.
Vincent soap, and then you sell them. Look, trinkets are weird down here in Mexico.
No shit. I still want to be the legendary mage.
Okay, legendary? One vote.
All right, yeah.
One vote, two votes for legendary mage. Loco, do you want to contest that?
I mean, I haven't seen any of these guys, but if I had to pick, I would go with Nameless One.
No, that's for hardcore people.
That's because you hate yourself, Loco.
We'll go with the legendary mage. Is legendary mage really okay? Yes, I think he's an okay person.
Take down the enemies with your bare hands. That's not a pun. That's me literally telling you to just slap an enemy to death.
You didn't need... Never mind, actually.
It's fine. Anyway, people saw our magic powers to save
I,
them.
For one, thought that needed a lot of clarification, actually.
It really didn't, though!
I thought Loco was implying that one of our spells gave us bare hands, and that would be awesome.
That would have been
great. I mean, it would.
You can also become a druid.
Cloths, and you're a baker, and they're not cloths.
Stick your hands in the bear cloths.
Yeah. And then when you're hurt, you eat your cloths.
Wow, that's a good spell.
I don't even know what anyone is talking about. Video games.
Are you not familiar with the pastry bear cloths?
No.
Oh.
No.
What the fuck do they teach you in Serbia? Jesus!
Maybe it's called something else. Maybe it's wolf balls or something.
No! What?
Is there a pastry called wolf balls in Serbia?
Well, there is a pastry called, like, cat paws, I guess? So, I don't know.
Wolf balls.
No.
It was paws!
Loco, for fucks. Don't make me redo this Let's Play a second fucking time.
Why did you bring him on, Bear? What is wrong with you?
It's a real question. I mishear everything. That's like kind of what I do.
Because you only have one headphone.
Yep. Wait, the size of battle? Yep. Oh, is this one of those in media res thingy gems?
Yeah, you heard of a world-ending power, and now you're here to fuck it up. Because you are a mighty mage.
Look at how thin we are, holy shit.
I mean, yeah, everybody else looks exactly thin, I don't know what you mean. Are we supposed to remember any of these guys' names?
No.
Okay.
So one of the defining features of this game is that everyone actually has a name. Including regular enemies, as you will see soon. So, don't bother remembering them.
Oh, okay.
To be fair, the regular enemies get some pretty good names.
Yeah.
Oh, I was expecting the gigantic sword to have a name.
Yeah, it's actually named Jeff.
Oh no.
So this seems like something we can... Oh, never mind.
Get fucked!
Wow, really? Already?
Could you have, like, jumped over those and maybe survived?
I believe that was the intent.
He jumped a bit too early, actually.
A little bit. A little bit.
That's right, death renders you naked.
I'm just glad we got to see the full range of magic power that we possess.
Yeah.
I tried to press square when I jumped, but it didn't work.
Oh, is square how we activate a spell?
No, he's been playing a shitload of Nier.
Yeah. Oh, is that the difficulty select?
So, I'm just gonna say
let's go to heaven.
Let's go to heaven.
Go to heaven, yeah.
Basically, you pick whether you want to go to heaven or hell, and if you go to heaven, you have to read this entire bit again.
I just wish there was a third option that said, let's rock.
Same.
I get it.
See, we have a fireball. That's good.
Oh, hey. Oh,
wow.
A dinky little fireball.
That was so devastating, wow. How could the boss stand against our might?
Do we have anything else to choose from down there at the bottom left?
No, we just specialized in fireball.
Yeah. Wow. We spend our entire life learning to be a mage and we only learn fireball.
And it's no explosion, like, but it's pretty good.
Staff, really. Why did...
Oh, it doesn't let me even jump off. Dumb game.
No, that was really good, actually.
I just jumped down.
Did the fall hurt you any, at least?
No, it just teleported me back into his fire.
Oh, okay. Do you think somebody has actually survived the scripted shenanigans?
Sorry, what was that?
I was wondering if anybody has actually survived the scripted shenanigans the same way that you can quote-unquote survive, you know, Demon Souls prologue until, you know, the scripted death.
I don't think you can.
I'm sure somebody's put it somewhere if you can.
Well,
Chosen Undead!
Not sure how many people actually have played this game because it didn't really get much traction after releasing.
It's also super janky.
Yeah. So this is us.
So, what is that squid thing?
So that squid thing is tutorial friend.
He's your new friend.
So he just tells us to follow him, and that's what we'll do because we don't really know what else to do. And we got one run.
Your fist was far more devastating looking than that fireball.
Yeah, actually.
I told you should have picked the nameless one.
No! What? No!
So remember the red letters, Purgatory Stones, because that means it's important to plot.
Okay.
How does one speak in red, anyway?
I'm assuming it's just being like very deep and emphasizing it, like purgatory stones. Yeah.
Actually, your character is synesthesia, apparently.
Possibly.
Yeah.
Wait, synesthesia something that makes you hear things, or?
No, look.
No, it's basically senses get kind of crosswired.
Yeah. Huh.
So like, in this case, like, hearing certain things will just elicit certain colors in your mind.
Can you seriously not take that bucket?
No, it doesn't give me a prompt.
I wish we could do a bucket percent run.
That would make this game really good.
Or at least wear the bucket on your head.
No, just...
So, I'm assuming if you fall in there, you die.
I assume so, but then again, when we jumped off the platform in hell, we didn't die.
But let's find out real quick.
Let's find out.
Yeah, I'm just wondering if there's fall damage when you actually...
No! Oh ho!
It is a secret.
That's just kind of a secret, or maybe this is an area that you're supposed to go to later.
No, it's not, because we already went through this once.
For some strange reason.
Will your stick kill you if you let it burn down?
Well, no.
I mean, it seems to be taking a while.
Whoa.
No, it's just... What? Oh.
No, that's just the way out. Okay.
Well, let's turn the hallway then.
Get in the hole.
Oh no, our stick got extinguished in the water. Oh shit, I think I set myself on fire.
Okay, you dumb motherfucker!
It's fine, wow!
It doesn't seem to be doing any damage to you, yeah.
Unlike the Scots.
This looks like a hallway that'll kill me.
Go!
Well, let's find out for sure.
Okay, there's a
chest. See, it's just a chest.
It's probably a mimic.
Yeah. It's a chest.
Open the chest before you destroy you, son of a bitch!
Yeah, I think I accidentally set on fire. This is not like, okay. Okay, let's go to the, Oh, wait, this one is also on fire. All my sticks are on fire, goddammit.
You are just made of fire at this point.
Is that a bad thing? It doesn't seem to be doing anything to you or the sticks.
He's just got a flaming stick down his pants now, Loco.
Don't judge.
It's making it really hard to interact with the world when I set it on fire constantly.
Yeah, because it just taps into things and lights them on fire.
See? Like, I approach this and now it's catching fire.
Can you not, can you not unequip everything? Your fists aren't on fire.
Not yet.
It would be nice if we could set our fists on fire. So, I know that Skelly Man was the one we should have followed, but really, we should probably just explore a bit.
Yeah.
Okay.
Because, you know, if a tutorial guy tells you to follow him, try your best not to follow him.
Yeah.
Especially if there's a trophy or an achievement related to it.
It's your buddy, Real Soviet Bear, noted contrarian.
There might be prizes.
And you're just agreeing with him, Chitlin, because you're also a contrarian.
Wouldn't that... No, actually...
Shut up. Don't worry about it!
That doesn't make a whole lot of sense, but you know...
If you disagree with somebody, you're agreeing with somebody else.
Okay, but let's talk about our buddy, Hell Jelly Fuentes.
And Hell Jelly Tillman.
I do love Hell Jelly Tillman. He is my best friend.
I do love the naming, it's really good.
Yeah.
Your best friend is dead.
Bentley.
Yeah. Oh, Bentley!
I actually had a dog named Bentley once upon a time.
Really?
Yeah.
So,
he was stupid as hell!
Is there a reason that these jellies are hostile to us?
They're enemies.
Named?
They're jellies.
Everything is named.
Yeah, but I was just wondering, like, who gave them their names?
They name themselves?
Probably their parents, I don't know. I don't know, do slimes have parents?
I mean, yes. It's their parent slime who splits off.
Okay,
let's give birth to them.
So, because we can't reach Bowman Johnson, we just have to break his tower and then we can reach him. Also, I'm out of stamina. Ow.
I was really... I thought you were giving him a dumb name like Bowman Johnson, but no.
That is literally what it does right there.
I'm trying really hard to find where my healing potion is.
Yeah, this... You actually found it. It's
trash.
Green.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, there we go.
Okay, good. We'll talk about the menu in a bit. As soon as I find where my weapon is.
Fucking radial overload.
Oh, ow, ow, ow.
Jesus Christ, wow. Bear.
Bowman.
Way to eat some shit, Bear.
Bowman Johnston
hurts.
Ain't taking none of your shit.
Well,
maybe
now
we
he's dead, so he
the
has
squid
to.
Skeleton. The squid a lot.
Okay, so we got a flame bottle.
Okay.
That sounds useful.
We got
it's called a Molotov
shirt.
A shirt.
And a heat potion. And a wood rod.
And we're living the high life.
Yeah. And now we have a
shirt. Choke down the flame potion.
No, not yet.
I just want us to get something to cover our face.
Also, I really hate the shirt design because it looks like we have like a little tail. That annoys me.
It's good.
I hate a lot of things about this character design.
It's like the rest of the game even isn't like that like badly designed visually. It's just the main character.
Yeah, which is weird.
I mean, that's sort of like the same problem Salt and Sanctuary had as well.
I mean, to be fair, Salt and Sanctuary overall is ugly and grimy and dingy as hell, and I hate it.
Yeah. I'm glad Skellyman is waiting there for us. Oh, wait, that's not where we can go.
Skellyman is way too patient.
And he's no Bowman Johnston.
I miss him already.
Maybe we'll
Nature
find
Jelly Sears. Oh.
Pickett is a good name, I appreciate it.
Is it?
Not really.
Yeah.
I don't know, I like Pickett.
Finally, you can become the battle mage you always wanted to be. Just without the magic.
We're not gonna learn any spells at all.
So here's the starter sword, which is double our size, I guess.
I hope you don't end up breaking it immediately on this rock.
And look, the only magic we need is sword, it's fine. Oh, now we have Bone Man Johnson!
Wait, was there a second Johnston?
Yeah.
No, Johnson!
Okay. Oh! I wonder if those are randomly generated for each enemy, or if every playthrough you'll always guaranteed find the same guy's name.
I'm pretty sure it's randomly generated.
It wouldn't make a whole lot of sense to, like, actively.
It's either
decide.
Yeah, it's either randomly.
I mean, you say that, but then you look at things like Ape Escape, and yeah, there are people that might do that.
Yes, but that's part of the package with Ape Escape. These things respawn.
I'm pretty sure it's either randomly generated, or they just did one seed and the game just uses that one seed for all the names.
No, because these are actual names, so I'm assuming they draw from a pool.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's just pulled out of a database. Somewhere.
I'm wondering if the pool is different based on the creature, because I noticed that like the fish were all getting like just standard girl names.
Possibly.
So like Chloe, Patty, there was one, Vita.
Vita, yeah. I have no idea what he's talking about.
Just the usual cryptic bullshit.
Cryptic anime bullshit.
That's true. I mean, look at how anime we are, just look at our hair.
I mean, does he have like a cowlick on the back of his head, or what's going on there?
It's spiked, sort of?
I mean, not really.
Is it sort of?
Also, we should probably eat.
Eat the mystery shroom.
So if you look below our purple icons, which I think are spell points, We have a hunger meter, so... It's another little mechanic this game has, which we will see how annoying it may be. It didn't seem annoying like, for starters.
This game seems to like kind of draw heavily from sort of more old school dungeon crawlers with that sort of thing.
Yeah.
Same thing with like the naming enemies like from a pool or shit like that.
Hmm. These little jingles do not fit the tone of the game.
They really don't.
Oh, I can block him.
This is rude, Bear. This isn't okay.
he's just trying to tutorialize you. Just let him go.
Just let him go and be cryptic wherever he may please.
Circle and R2 to use items. Very important.
Yeah, don't hit R2 on accident trying to dodge.
So there's a teleporting pod that just literally shoots us with no transition back to where we started.
That looks unfinished.
actually, I'm pretty sure it's they load the map as in its entirety.
Yeah, but you still
for the given area.
You still want some kind of screen effect or transition for it.
What we need is a star wipe.
Oh, do not do star wipes.
Is something wrong with star wipes?
There's a lot of things wrong with a lot of wipes.
Bear, when you put this video up, can you put a star wipe in place of the transition?
I will do my best.
You're gonna regret indulging Chitlin, ever.
I don't know what you're talking about, I always have good ideas.
So is there a plot right now other than, you know...
No, we're fucking dead, we need to get Purgatory Stones, that's it.
Basically, yep. This is the afterlife, and we're just being told, hey, the afterlife is fucked, you should probably get the Purgatory Stones done, fuck it. And we're like, okay, sure.
Wait, so is the afterlife fucked because we died, or is it just like, by coincidence, hero, since you died, maybe you can fix things up here?
I believe the afterlife was fucked before we got here. It wouldn't make any sense that the afterlife only gets fucked after we die.
Some random asshole mage.
For the afterlife for some reason. Or maybe the dragon that we're fucking up is one of those afterlife fucking dragons, like in Skyrim.
Please don't talk about an afterlife fucking dragon, I don't need this.
Yeah, please, Loco. This is a PG-13 Let's Play.
You say that, but I've already said fuck more than twice.
I mean, that's generally accepted now.
Is it?
Well, in normal countries, it is.
I'm not sure of the limitations on the word fuck in PG-13. I'm not sure you're allowed to say fuck in PG-13.
I think you can only say it once.
I don't classify as PG-13 anymore.
Yeah, I thought the general rule of thumb is you can only say it once. That's it.
Gasp. But anyway, that aside, like... You know, Skyrim had that one dragon that was, like, eating souls at the doors of Valhalla or something, remember?
Yeah, Skyrim also fucking sucked.
I mean, that's whoa.
Hey, he's not wrong.
I can't believe we said it 3 times. Now we're in trouble. No, but you know what I mean. Like, maybe that dragon is doing something similar. You know how dragons are, very unoriginal.
Much like Skyrim.
Yes.
Can't believe how rude y'all are.
Oh, okay, so you strafe whenever you use your shield?
Yep. Well, you strafe if you lock on to someone. Oh! What? Oh!
Wow!
Wow.
Wait, how did you die?
I kicked instead of blocking because I pressed heavy attack to throw my... fireball thing, but the game decided no you didn't. Okay, let's just get off of it.
So there was no consequence?
In the tutorial area apparently no. There will be consequences later.
Yeah.
But we also kept our items.
It respawns all the items.
Huh.
That's weird.
That seems odd.
Do you lose your items after death? It doesn't seem
no, we already had our shield equipped, so obviously not.
We could have infinite round shields.
Yeah.
We could wear our second shirt as pants.
No. What? No. Is the neck hole for your dong? This is important.
It's obviously the poop chute.
Wow. Unbelievable. I'm just gonna kill Silas here.
Oh yeah, you should have checked if the names were the same.
I mean, I don't remember the names of my foes anymore.
Yeah.
Well, that you kill that the bowman that you killed still call himself Williamson.
What?
It doesn't matter.
Oh.
It generally doesn't matter at all.
Literally nothing matters.
I mean, I didn't say that it mattered. I was just asking.
This is not a completionist Leslie.
What?
Are you supposed to collect one of every name?
No, this is just a monster book for the general monster types you've killed.
No, I wasn't asking about the bestiary. I was just wondering how remembering the name of a single enemy made it a completionist Leslie.
Well, you know, confirming how all the mechanics in the game work. Look, we'll probably die enough and then we'll be able to compare names. It'll be fine. Don't worry about it.
Alright. I guess.
Open the damn chest!
I really look forward to finding out if there's names that are static.
I do like that you have to get this book and read it to learn how to fucking dash.
Yeah. Just like real life.
Wait, that is actually what happened. That's...
Yeah.
You actually anime run. Wow.
Yeah, you do the fucking trundle. It's really good.
God damn it.
Wait, it's called the grundle?
No. No, Loco. God, no.
Please, let's not talk about the taint. I don't need this, Loco.
I genuinely didn't understand what you said.
I know. We know you don't understand.
I said trundle with a T.
What do you have to expand my vocabulary with words that are difficult to understand?
It's not difficult.
Look, I know English isn't your first language, but goddamn.
No, I genuinely didn't. I genuinely heard. You know what I heard. I won't say it again if I don't have.
I'm glad you know grundle and not trundle. And now it's teaching you how to lock on. That's pretty good.
Yeah, and now it's teaching me how to fucking dodge. You can only dodge when locking on.